Colin Kaepernick, the statistically dwindling former 49ers quarterback who likes to be on his knee, has joined an ungrateful protest that seems to be against America. Kaepernick joined the Indigenous People's Sunrise Gathering on Alcatraz Island, which is being touted as the un-Thanksgiving celebration. It's a little gathering that features Native American activists and commemorates the people's occupation of Alcatraz. This reportedly lasted from 1969 until 1971 and perhaps forced changes in the government to favor things required by Indian affairs. There's also speak of the holiday being talked up as the current day American genocide, but that's no responsibility of mine or yours. Colin Kaepernick was quoted as saying, "Our fight is the same fight. We're all fighting for our justice, for our freedom," which doesn't make much sense. He's a millionaire former pro quarterback, so not sure what fight he's fighting. Perhaps he's battling all the white privilege he has since he was raised by adoptive parents who seem to be better off than most. What struggles does Kaepernick have in his life? His only problems are not being hired by any NFL team on account of his falling stats and extreme baggage. His bank account and home is likely bigger than most, so he's not homeless or poor, which means he has the financial freedom to do as he pleases. From Breitbart, _ former San Francisco 49ers quarterback Colin Kaepernick joined the annual un-Thanksgiving protest Thursday by Native American activists at the Indigenous People's Sunrise Gathering on Alcatraz Island. _ The demonstration is held each year to commemorate the occupation of Alcatraz in 1969 by Native American activists, which lasted until 1971 and which is credited with encouraging changes in the federal government's policy toward Indian affairs, the East Bay Times reports. If Europeans came to America and stole land from people, then that's history and simply what happened. Neither I, you, or Colin Kaepernick can change history. To protest and be thankless and ungrateful for what we all have today is disrespectful to those who truly have nothing. Kaepernick can protest all he wants while people sleep on the street and live their daily life being thankful to find a half-eaten sandwich in the trash. With all due respect, if you can't protect your land, then you don't deserve the land anyway. But that's neither here nor there. Whatever happened decades before any of us were born is pointless to protest. We're here now when we need to worry about today's problems, not the battles fought in the past. It's just like slavery. No one on this planet has ever owned a slave, nor were they a slave, so continuing to use it as a talking point is essentially pointless. Leave history in the past and work on the present. Kaepernick should encourage people to work hard and fight for the homeless, the veterans, oh wait, he disrespects them, and building communities that focus on reducing crime and increasing education. It seems like Kaepernick wastes more time instead of being productive. Kaepernick talks about the resistance and the fight. _ He added, according to the San Francisco Chronicle, _ if there's one thing that I take away from today and seeing the beauty of everybody out here, it's that we're only getting stronger every day. We're only getting larger and larger every day. I see the strength in everybody. The dancing, the rituals, that is our resistance. We continue to fight. We continue to fight for justice. We fight for our freedom, and we continue on that path. Resistance to what? Fight what? What justice are they fighting for? What freedom are they fighting for? None of this resistance talk makes any sense. I'm not sure what they're resisting against, as there simply is nothing against them to resist. The resist movement is mostly people who enjoy protesting who have no true cause, or can't grasp the concept that they're fighting for things they already have, but they're too blind to realize it. There's already justice in America, and when people stop defending criminals, then they'll realize justice already prevails in most situations. The people fighting for freedom already have freedom thanks to the military who fought for our freedom. How can anyone say they're protesting, resisting, or fighting for the freedom they want, when they already have it? That doesn't make much sense and sounds like a pointless reason to protest or resist anything. If they want to talk about resisting something, then let's talk about those extremely not at all affordable Affordable Care Act. Remember when Obama said we could keep our doctor, But we couldn't keep our doctor? That's something worth resisting. What part of the act is affordable? I resist. It's great that he's out there doing things, but why not do something for the homeless veterans in his neighborhood? Why not clean up the streets where American people struggle to eat? Colin Kaepernick is still not on any NFL team, despite the fact that he's probably better than a handful of backup QBs. He's not an elite player, he's not worth big money, and he comes with social justice warrior baggage that no one wants to carry for him. Teams have resisted to hire him, so I guess his resistance worked against him. If you can't get the Cleveland Browns to hire you, then you know you're the problem. Kaepernick should be thankful for the millions he earned while given the once-in-a-lifetime chance to be a professional athlete. Hopefully he's secretly thankful for that opportunity while he's out there protesting for things that he already has, except for a job.